Good evening, children. As you all know, so our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhiji, came to India from South Africa. So in South Africa, he fought against apartheid. When he came to India, he fought against Britishers to get us independence. He used two methods in his freedom struggle. The first one is non-violence. And the second very important one is Satyagraha. So these are the two important methods or new methods which were used by Gandhiji in his freedom struggle, and he used it and he got freedom for our India. So in this, so he started so many movements also. Not only methods were used by Gandhiji, he launched many movements to fight against Britishers. So among his movements, so one is very very important, so that is non-cooperation movement. So in this class, we will discuss about non-cooperation movement, which was launched by Gandhiji in 1920. So Gandhiji launched this non-cooperation movement to fight against Britishers in 1920. So there are so many causes responsible for this movement. So very importantly, the first one is Khilafat movement. The second cause is Rowlatt Act, and the third cause is Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So these are the important three causes which led to non-cooperation movement, which was launched by Gandhiji in 1920. So in this class, I would like to discuss about this first cause. So as you people know that, so during First World War, so this is the period of First World War. So during this period, the whole European countries were divided into two blocks. One block was led by Britishers and the other block was led by Germany. So in this war, means in First World War, Britishers won over Germany, or Germany was defeated by Britishers. When Britishers won this war, so many restrictions were imposed on Germany. Okay, not only on Germany, so many restrictions also imposed on Germany's friends also, or their allied powers also. For example, Turkey. So when Britishers not only imposed restrictions on Germany, when they imposed restrictions on Turkey, so this was not liked by Muslims. So Muslims means Indian Muslims who were there in India. Why? Because when they imposed restrictions on Turkey Sultan, so he was a religious, spiritual or leader, a religious leader of the Muslims. So when they imposed a lot of restrictions on a religious leader of the Muslims, this act was not liked by Indian Muslims. So Indian Muslims understood the true nature of Britishers. Now they don't want, okay, Britishers to rule over India. But before this, they did not understand the true nature of Britishers. They become loyal towards the Britishers. When they started imposing restrictions on Turkey Sultan, then they understood the real nature of Britishers. So now for that they decided, okay, so we will go against this Britishers. We will not support Britishers. We will not be loyal to the Britishers. Okay, for that reason, so in India, they wanted to launch a movement against a Britisher that is famously known as the Khilafat movement. Okay, so this movement was launched by two brothers. They are famously known as Ali brothers. So Ali brothers, so in Ali brothers, first one is Muhammad Ali and the second one is Shaukat Ali. So these two brothers, they wanted to start this Khilafat movement against Britishers. Why? Because they imposed a lot of restriction and they wanted to lower the powers of Turkey Sultan. So for that reason, they wanted to stop, or they wanted to stop loyal towards Britishers in India. Okay, then when this Ali brothers wanted to start this Khilafat Bharat movement, Gandhiji thought that this is the better opportunity to unite Hindus and Muslims. So Gandhiji spoke to this Ali brothers. Even Ali brothers also accepted, okay, so we will support to your non-cooperation movement, okay. So he told that, so Gandhiji told that, so it is not only Hindu movement, so you people come and even we will show support for this Khilafat movement. Then finally Gandhiji so merged this Khilafat movement with the non-cooperation movement, and this become a first cause to launch this non-cooperation movement. The second one is Rowlatt Act. So the second, this Rowlatt Act was introduced by Justice Rowlatt. According to this act, so without any trial, the person or Indian can be imprisoned for 2 years. This was not liked by Gandhiji, and Gandhiji mentioned this Rowlatt Act as a black bill, okay. So for that reason, he wanted to fight against Britishers, and he told Britishers to stop this act. But that Rowlatt, Justice Rowlatt was not ready to accept. So against this, he imposed a martial law, okay. So but many village people, they were not aware of this martial law which was imposed in India, but they wanted to attend the fair which was there in Jallianwala Bagh. Then they just went to Jallianwala Bagh to take part in a fair, okay. So there also the meeting they conducted and all, but General Dyer got that, so people are going to Jallianwala Bagh to discuss about the Britishers, so they wanted to launch any movement against the Britishers. So suddenly that they got General Dyer went to Jallianwala Bagh, he closed the exit, and many people they wanted to go from there, they wanted to escape from this Jallianwala Bagh, but they couldn't do that, okay. Okay, because only one entry and only one exit was there. Many people, they never wanted to die because of that Britishers' bullets. They started jumping into the well. Many men died, then many women with their children. Many people sacrificed so during this period. So these three reasons so which led to non-cooperation movement, Gandhiji felt that so we have to start one mass movement against this act. And finally in 1920, with the help of Muslims, with the help of other community people, so he started or launched a non-cooperation movement in India in 1920, okay. In our next class, hope you people understood, children. So in next class, we will discuss about the impact of non-cooperation movement.